Hi, and welcome to episode 1 of the Flying Yak podcast. Today is Friday, April 29th, and from this week on, I will hopefully be showing you what I'm doing in my life as a knitter slash spinner in Reykjavik, Iceland. You can find me on Instagram at the_flying_yak. This week, I will be talking about my whips, FOs, spinning, and probably a few other things that pop into my head. Without further ado, let's hop into some whips. My first whip has been on the needles for about a week and a half now, and or since the Tuesday before last, and it has been an absolute joy in mindlessness. It is the Chittagong from the Container Ships collection by Anne Weaver, and I'm knitting this out of half out of my own hand spun and half out of a silk mohair lace from Sandnes Garn of Norway, which is this one here. It's really nice. It's really drapey. Like every other mohair, it kind of likes to tangle on itself, so it's a bit of a pain in that way. I had two balls of this. This is the second ball. The first one I undid from the middle, which was a mistake. When I got to the final ply of the ball, it was just not heaven, so I kind of undid that. But yes, this is the shawl. I've done some knitter math, and it's at about 1,200 stitches on the needle right now. So you started from the middle, whoop, with a little square, 10 by 10. I'm really bad at this camera stuff. Yes, 10 by 10. And then you use raglan increases, and you just increase every other round 8 stitches like you would a sweater, except you're increasing on a shawl. And you use all of your first color. You just knit until you run out of yarn, which is my favorite type of pattern. I hate counting. And then you add on your second color, and you start adding in these wedges where you increase every round 4 stitches on each like middle. Like you have your square, then on the points that would be the diamond, you increase wedges there. It makes a really interesting shape. I'm loving knitting on it so far, but now that these rounds have gotten so extreme, I'm trying to avoid not putting it down for fear of like just never picking it up again, because I know that a round is currently taking me like 45 minutes. And if I put it down, it's just, I'm never going to pick it up. But yes, the hand spun is a 2-ply lace weight. It's about 860 meters. It's in the Seasick colorway by Hello Yarn. I think it's absolutely beautiful. I'm not, in the braid you could see the blue a lot more. There's just one stripe of the solid blue. I fractally spun it, and like the main brown and yellow are kind of taking over. You can see it in the marl here. It's really pretty. But when it's blue and yellow, you can't really see it. It just looks a little green. It happens when you have a lace weight, you can't really see the plies that well. If it were chunkier, you could really see that blue take over. But I'm kind of okay with this. I'm hoping to get this done this weekend and then just be able to wear it. It's one of those things that I want for the product. The knitting's fine, it's keeping me busy, but I really mostly want the finished item, especially with the silk mohair on the edge. It's so soft. Not that cordale isn't soft, but mohair. Gotta love it. So this is the first whip that I'm working on. I've been kind of monogamous in my knitting this week, which is absolutely unlike me. I have about 6 sweaters on the needles right now, just because I really like sweaters, but I like casting things on. I like casting anything on. Because when it's really small, you can see it grow really fast. And when it's a big jellyfish, you can knit 20 rows and then you still can't see what you've done. This project is in my only knitting bag. So whatever's on the go, I kind of just shove in here. It's a large wedge from the Fat Squirrel. It's her granny fabric. I've had it for about a year. Look at this granny. I'm in love with her. If you love this fabric, it's on Spoonflower. I found it. I kind of want to make everything in my house from that fabric. Like, I need an apron with just happy veggies and grannies on it. But I'm showing a little bit of self-restraint on that one. Just because shipping is so expensive. That's what happens when you live on an island. Next whip is socks. I finished the main body, This is my own sock pattern. It's my lazy as all hell sock pattern. See these? It's hand spun. I never knit with hand spun, and then I kind of had a lot of hand spun adding up. So a few weeks ago, I made the decision that I would knit with my hand spun because I have a lot of stash. This is my stash wall. It's a new addition in my apartment. It's slowly going up just because it takes so long to wind all these cakes, but I love it. I really enjoy it. I get to see everything I have. Everything was in bins, and it really wasn't making me happy. But yes. Anyways, handspun socks. These are from Fleece Artist, I think they're called. Yeah, they're Fleece Artist from the Maritimes of Canada. I thought they were called Fiber Artist, so when I was looking them up for the show notes, I just kept on, like, really trying hard to Google it. Fleece Artist. Yep. This is from their Merino Sliver, so it's 100% Merino. I can't remember if it's superwash or not. I spun it at a fingering weight. Got about 450 yards, or 450 meters. It's a Navajo plied, as you can see. I wanted to keep the colors pretty straight. It's a little palindromatic, but yes. Lazy. This is my lazy sock for a lot of reasons. It's the most afterthought sock pattern you can possibly do without doing a provisional cast on, which I also sometimes do. So what I do is I cast on a toe using the Turkish cast on, and then I just knit until I ran out of yarn. So I left enough yarn on this one for a hexapuff, which I will be talking about later. But and then you squish it together, you do another toe, and then you bind off. So you have two toes. And then you squish them together, and you find the halfway point. And then you pick up your stitches along here, and you do two cuffs using whatever other yarn in your life. And then once you have that, you have two socks. And then you do an afterthought heel on either side, like that. So I left this one whole so I could show you guys my lazy as all hell socks. If anyone's interested in a pattern, I could probably write one up in like a Twitter post. Because it's a really quick pattern. It's knit until you run out of yarn. My favorite strategy. This is great for like movie theater knitting or car knitting or bar knitting because you don't need to think at all. You can just knit and then you're done. I knit these on 9-inch circular needles on 2 millimeters. I like a tighter gauge, especially when it's hand spun, and especially when there's no nylon content. Also, the 9-inch needle, I don't think I have one here. No, it's the, like, mini circular needle. It's about this big, and it holds all your stitches, and you can just knit in the round really quick. I think it might slow me down. I've kind of gotten used to them. I've been knitting on 9-inch circulars for a while now. But I mostly use them because when I do magic loop, every time I move the needle, I'm like, look at how much work I've gotten done. Look at these pretty socks. Oh my god. And then I put the needle in, then I knit across another half round. And I'm like, wow, these are beautiful. And then I keep going. But I take like a 10-second break at every magic loop. So it's not that magical. It's mostly me being like, wow, I'm such a great knitter. And then moving on. But it takes me a while to move on. These ones I'll knit like, there's never a pause. It's just like knit, 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 knit. Sock. So it's a nice change. I get more done that way. Also, next on the whips, it's like a kind of whip. It's mostly finished. It's the Lobelia cardigan from PomPom Quarterly from one of their first issues. I think it was issue 4. It's a teeny, teeny crop top. I haven't blocked it yet. It's done. It's off the needles. I just need to weave in ends, but I need to sew on some buttons. So I sewed on, look at these buttons, they're little itty bitty cats. I'm obsessed with these buttons. So as you can see, there's a long button band, there are two cats. I have 7 cats to go. I sewed on the first cat, and I was like, okay, I can do this. Then I sewed on the second cat, and I was like, oh my god, I hate sewing, and then stopped about a week ago. So that's still, I know it's like 40 minutes of sewing that I need to do for about 40 hours of knitting. Not like 20. but I couldn't do it. So this is the yarn on this one is Dyfor yarn from the UK. It's a yarn that was new to me. This is her Tussah, I'm assuming it's a lady. It's a Tussah Silk lace yarn in the Glass Frog colorway. This person has the best colorway names. I'd recommend just going to their Etsy shop and just reading them. They're spectacular. But yeah, the pattern has some lace in the raglan increases that is absolutely beautiful. I'm in love with it. This color isn't about right. I think the intense color behind me is kind of oversaturating on the blue, but it's a little more lively. It's a little more teal. It's coming across very gray, but it's done. Also, there's this cable detail on the ribbing that I absolutely love. It's a twisted cable. It was a pain in the butt. I don't think I'm ever going to do a twisted cable ribbing across this many stitches again. It was knit flat. Just because I would have knitted in the round had I used a wool yarn, but a steek on silk just didn't seem right to me. One, cutting a lot of silk, and then two, it doesn't fell to itself, so it would have fallen apart really quickly. Or that's just what I think would have happened, so I was kind of playing it safe. I'm not a big purler. I call myself a knitter, not a purler. Just because purls are a pain. But no, I'm very pleased with how it came out. I had a little bit of a international issue where the pattern said knit from the armpit for 12 centimeters, and I read 12 inches. I knit about double what I needed, and then I was like, wait a second, isn't this a crop top? And then it was 4 inches. So I knit to about 10 inches until I was like, this is past my butt. And then I ripped out a lot. So much. And yeah, it took me a while. I got the cables wrong. I did the cross too fast. So they're supposed to be longer. They're a little short. But I'm okay with that. I'm not gonna redo anything at this point. Never, no. No. This is gonna get the buttons on. Gonna block it. Gonna wear it every day. I really like how it looks. I love the finished object. I just don't like sewing at all. Yeah, that's the Lobelia. Oh, it was by Meghan Fernandes, and I knit it on 3.75 needles. Also the same needles that I'm currently knitting the Chittagong on. I like it. It's a little smaller than a 4, so I feel like I'm knitting something on very small needles, but it's also just about a 4, so it's fine. I have these weird notions that anything that's 4 millimeters or more is like chunky weight. Anything that's smaller than 4 millimeters is like sock weight. Anything that's knit on small needles, like a sweater, I just like, I must be an amazing, this is like, what's the word? Not antique. But when something's like lace and heritage, I know you all know the word, like really nice lace, and it's knit on like half millimeter needles, and the wedding ring shawls are that, that's what I feel like I'm knitting whenever I'm on small needles. My last whip for this week is something I cast on at the bar the other night because I needed something to knit and I didn't have any socks for some reason. So this is my broken seed hat, broken seed stitch hat. It is a sock pattern originally, and I just blew it up. So it's really pretty. I love this stitch pattern. I've had this pattern favorited on Ravelry for like 3 years as socks, but I only do vanilla lazy butt socks. So I decided I would just do it as a hat. The yarn is more hand spun. I've never had more than one handspun project on the needles at a time, and I currently have 3. I am beside myself. But this is a handspun single ply. How do I get the color right? There we go. It's from Woolfinch Studios, which I'm pretty sure is based out of the UK, in their Desert Dance colorway. It was a style of roving that had really interested me. It's a bunch of colors, but in the braid, the roving rope, instead of the colors being like color 1, color 2, color 3, color 4, color 5, repeat, it was like color 1, color 2, color 3. So they're all kind of blended on the horizontal instead of on the vertical. And I was really curious about how it would spin up without being muddy. Tr- turns out if you spin it into a worsted, it will be muddy and awful. So I kept it as a one ply because I thought, like, the more you ply, the muddier it gets. I don't know. I'd have to buy, like, 4 braids of it and really try it out. I'm not really experienced with this. And I'm not a really experienced single ply yarn knitter either, as you can see from how overspun this is. I've got a really overspun spot. It's not bad everywhere. But, yeah, I think it's really pretty. It's a lot of thick and thin, but I'm mixing it with a Icelandic lopi, which also you can get at the grocery store here. Lopis, like, everywhere. I work at the main store that sells lopi. It's everywhere. But this is the white lietlopi, so it's their light worsted weight. I really like it. I think they go really well together. This is not going to be for me, though. It's a little too big, but I enjoy it. Very pleased with how it's turning out. The stitch, the white kind of tames down the crazy muddy. Yeah. That's all my whips. That's a lot of whips. It took me like 15 minutes to walk through all my whips. That's not too bad. Some podcasters are worse. Worst or better. I now have my FOs. I don't have that many FOs this week. I'm currently working on the beekeeper cult, like everyone in the knitting world is or will be at some point. It's probably the most beautiful knitting pattern I've ever seen, and I'm obsessed with it. It just takes so long. So long. Why would anybody cast this on? So I started it about 3 years ago, and it is my longest running whip. I don't think I'm ever going to finish it. It's never going to be done. But I go into, like, hexapuff phases. So for those of you who haven't seen the beekeeper cult, you make these little puffs. Whoop, whoop, whoop. This one's crooked. So yeah, there's these little hexagons, which are called hexapuffs, which are the cutest thing to ever happen to the world. And then you make one of them and you're like, oh my god, I have a finished object! Done! And then you make another one. You're like, oh, they're buddies! Done! And then you make 700. Not buddies. Not fun. Super fun. Super squishy. But yeah. I want to make 700. I'm at about ballpark the 100 mark. I go in waves. I'll make like 20, and then I'll go 6 months without making any. So, and then you tie them together at the corners like this, and you make a little hexagon world. I made 4 this week, which is not bad. This one, that was one, and the first two, which is a good week. They take about 45 minutes to make, which is way too much for an inch by an inch of knitting, I think. But they're great, and they're fun to throw around, and they're everywhere in my house. I just finish it, and I'll put it down somewhere because I think it's cute, and then I lose them. So I don't have an actual count of how many hexapuffs I have. I just have a lot of hexapuffs. These 3, yarn-wise, are from mini skeins from Nicole C Mendez. I'm in her mini skein club. Love mini skein clubs. This is my first time in a yarn club. I don't know how I feel about other people picking my yarn, but because it was like mini skeins, it feels more fun. So, and there are 10 colors instead of just 1. So mini skeins are like, I have a few here. This is from our most recent club. You get 10 gram skeins. So these are all the pinks and purples. Not a pink and purple person, but they're really nice. Yeah, I especially like this one with like the gray. It's a little more orange on camera than it is in real life. They're really nice. Each one of these is 10 grams or 40 meters. And I can get like 3 or 4 hexapuffs out of one, or 3 or 4 heels and toes, or they're great for that. And especially because I do a lot of afterthought heels, I was pretty excited. The first club was mostly like lightly variegated solids. This is one of them. This is another one. I haven't used it yet. But you get 10 every month. So they're a lot of fun. They also fill the holes in the wall. So they're good for that. That is a long ongoing FO. Hopefully I'll finish at least once a week. One a week. And I'll get to show you these little smushies. They're super fun to smush. A lot of people fill them with polyfill, but because I have access to so much yarn at work, I just kind of stuff them with what's called plied lopé, which is the flat, unspun lopé. I just kind of stuffed them. There's so much at work. The advantages of working at a yarn store. Oh, this puff. That was my favorite puff of the week. It's in the Monet, I think, colorway from Hedgehog Fibers Inner Singles. Merino Singles. Add some leftover. I made a cowl. It's all the way over there. But I made a cowl out of it from the Stephen West bundled in brioche. Obsessed. Yes, segue. Whoa, Stephen West. I finished, not this week, a little while ago, but I'm going to show you just as a precursor. I finished the boneyard shawl out of the, it said any weight, any gauge, went with bulky. Yeah, this is the boneyard shawl. It's pretty big. I'll show you half of it so you can just see how big it is. Yes, this is half of the wingspan and the depth, and it's quite large. This is my own hand dyed. It's not in the shop. I don't know why. This is 250 grams. My hand dyed is on the Lopi yarn that I sell. So it is out of the Aulafos Lopi. I really liked it. It's fun and speckly, but it's like you just like took this, made it really, really, really big. It was a good quick knit. But this is, as some of you may know, this is the first pattern that Stephen West ever put out. So it is a free pattern. It is very simple, it's a fun knit, super duper easy. It looks really cute if you make it really big. It's like a kerchief. You could knit it out of any weight, it's great. And it, you finish it with a little bit of garter stitch. I should have finished it earlier. I do not have enough garter stitch for my liking, but it doesn't curl too bad. And then, it looks cute. But this is the first Stephen West pattern. And my goal with this podcast, along with also just making one of those regular fancy podcasts that everybody likes, I was hoping to knit through every single West Knits pattern. So all of the patterns that Stephen West has ever released in order. So this is the first one. It is done. Dunzo bunzo. I enjoyed it. I haven't blocked it. Blocking. I have hardwood floors. So if I want to block something, it means I have to do it on my bed. Which means I have to wake up a little bit earlier to go to work before work and like soak it and then pin it to my bed. And it means also that it can't take a nap that day. And I'm never ready in the morning to commit to not taking a nap 6 hours later. So I just haven't blocked it. It's not too bad. It could be better. But yes, anyways, back to the Stephen West along world. So I am in love with Stephen West, but I haven't really knit any of his patterns. So I'm gonna knit them all. That's the dream. I think there are 280 patterns. 250, something along those lines. There are a lot of patterns, and there are like 8 blankets, 200 shawls, and I hope to knit them all and see how that goes. I think I'll really enjoy that. What a better way than watch how somebody grew than knit through all their knitting. So I'm gonna be, this is the first one of many, many, many Stephen West finished objects, hopefully. I will cast on the second one this week with some leftovers and maybe finish it. We'll see. Onwards, forwards and onwards. I have one FO in the spinning world. It is from Hedgehog Fibers. I haven't soaked it or thwacked it or done any of that business with it yet. So it's a little crinkly. This is from the, I think they're called Itty Bits. Yeah. Itsy Bitsy Fiber. So you get this, sorry about the crinkle. Ugh, I know I personally don't like the crinkle, but you get this tall of a bag with about 500 grams of fiber. 250? 250 grams of fiber. I bought 500. I got two of them. And they come in these little nuggets of fun mystery fibers. So this is like a leftover of something. Then you can undo them. I haven't undone this one yet. Then you get this fun bit of roving that's like 8 grams, 12 grams. And they're so much fun. They're so pretty. There's a lot of different fibers. This one is like a really nice alpaca. I haven't spun alpaca yet. This might be fun. But there, I also got the one that I decided to spin first as like a test spin of the little nugget swirl. Was one that looked like this. I have no idea what this fiber is. If someone can tell me what this fiber is, I would really appreciate it. But you kind of, yeah, this is another nugget. I don't know if it's like, yeah, it's like plastic. It's kind of, it's really weird. It might be just like an acrylic. At first I thought it was like 100% just stellina, but it's not stellina. I think it's just acrylic. It says it might, it can be anything from like, someone tell me if anyone knows. But this is the yarn that I got. I put it in a mini hank. I spun the like, the flashy fun ply is the yarn that I spun, and then I plied it with the black regia sock yarn. Just what I, something black that I had in the stash because I thought it would look very disco. I'm really happy with how it turned out. There's a lot of fuzz around the sparkle. I'm not sure how it'll look once it's washed. We'll kind of see how that goes. I'm really excited about this sparkle yarn. I didn't measure it. I really should have. There might be like 50 meters of yarn here. Tops 50 meters. 60. I'm thinking about doing like the edging on a hat with this yarn and then the rest in black or white or pink. I'm not sure. These are not my colors, but I'm very pleased with how it turned out. It's very fun. I don't know. It's great. That's my only spinning FO for this week. And finally, I don't have my bobbins. They're plugged into the wheel and I didn't much about spinning done, but I'm also spinning this. This is 50 grams, very compacted, but it's Wensleydale from Hello Yarn in the Eat Your Greens colorway. It's just a little treat of what's coming. It's very skinny. I enjoy it. I ripped, for the braid, I just ripped it in half, and I'm hoping to spin them together to get a gradient. It's not going to sync up. I know myself, I'm not that good of a spinner, but it's going to be a two-ply lace. Fingers crossed. I think that's it. As for stash enhancement, stash adoptions, guilt, I went to my yarn store this week, and I work in a yarn store next to a yarn store. So on my commute, I pass in front of the expensive yarn store, and I work at the local Icelandic wool yarn store, and every time I try to get there a little early so I can sneak in and look at their stuff. And this week I didn't buy yarn, so I bought some scissors to reward myself for not buying yarn. I've wanted these bird scissors for a very long time. I'm very happy with them. They're cute. They're very sharp. They cut everything so flat and straight and not frayed. They're amazing. I highly recommend bird-shaped scissors. Everybody needs a pair. I didn't buy yarn this week, except for the yarn that's on the edging of the shawl, the Chittagong, the mohair from Norway. It doesn't count though, because it's almost an FO. It didn't even touch the stash. It just went from the grocery bag to the project. I think I put it on the project in the car. So not stash, does not count. I don't think I have anything else to say, except I'm really sorry for how much I need to touch my hair. It's mostly backwards, and I haven't showered yet. That's top quality podcast right there. No shower. But yeah, thank you for joining me on the inaugural flagship episode of The Flying Yak. I'll be trying to put one out every Friday, because I have days off on Friday. We're gonna see. I'm gonna hold myself to putting one on Friday. If you guys want a Ravelry group or something like that, please tell me. I will make one. If you have any questions, comments, or compliments, please comment section. I think it's there most places. So thank you so much. Have a great week, and I hope to bring you more knitty yarn-based things in the future.